Hello friends, today I'm going to discuss about precipitation and co-precipitation under gravimetric analysis. So first I'm going to discuss about precipitation technique. What is precipitation technique? In this technique, first we will take an analyte solution, then we will add precipitating agent that will precipitate out the analyte, and that analyte will be analyzed in the form of precipitate. So here again I am taking the same example of barium chloride. Barium chloride will be the analyte. H2SO4 will be precipitating agent. It will convert in the form of BaSO4, that will be precipitate. Apart from this, it will also produce HCl. So in this reaction, barium sulfate will be the precipitate. Now coming to the limitations of this precipitation technique in gravimetric analysis. So first limitation is that precipitated compound must be convertible into pure compound by ignition or by simple evaporation method. Second limitation is that precipitated compound must be free from impurities. Third limitation is that precipitated compound must be insoluble in that solution. Last limitation is that precipitated compound must be easily separated by using simple filtration process. Now coming to the co-precipitation. So co-precipitation is the precipitation of more than one compound or substance in the solution. So in gravimetric analysis, this co-precipitation is a problem because impurities may be co-precipitated along with the analyte. This co-precipitation problem is overcome in gravimetric analysis by two processes. First one is digestion and the second one is dissolving the precipitate, then re-precipitating the compound. So in digestion, we will warm the solution so small precipitate will be dissolved and then it will be converted into the larger crystals or larger particles of the precipitate. And in this process, first we will dissolve the precipitate, then again we will re-precipitate that compound, so we will get pure precipitate without impurities. Now coming to the mechanism of co-precipitation. So co-precipitation occurs due to mainly four mechanisms. First one is inclusion, second one is occlusion, third one is adsorption, and the fourth one is mechanical entrapment. So first I am going to discuss about inclusion. So inclusion is mainly a crystallographic defect. In this defect, impurities will occupy the lattice site in the crystal structure. For example, this is crystal structure and it contains two ions. One is x plus and another one is y minus. Here in the same solution we are having an ion that is z plus, means charge of this x plus and z plus will be same. So this z plus will replace one of the x ion in this crystal structure like this. So in this crystal structure, this Z plus is impurity and this will be known as inclusion. Now coming to the second mechanism, that is occlusion. When foreign ions or adsorbed impurities gets physically entrapped inside the fast growing precipitate, then it is known as occlusion. So here during precipitation, if crystal is rapidly growing and it contains x plus and y minus, then one z plus will be entrapped inside the crystal structure, then it will be known as this occlusion. So here Z plus is the impurity, and what is difference between inclusion and occlusion? Here physical entrapment takes place, means Z plus is not replacing anything, it is just physically entrapped inside this crystal structure, means apart from Z plus any impurity may be entrapped. But if we are talking about this X plus, then here X plus is replaced by Z plus, means charge of this X plus and charge of this Z plus should be similar. So ultimately here Z plus is replacing X plus, but in occlusion nothing is replaced, it will be physically entrapped. Now coming to the next one, that is mechanical entrapment. So under mechanical entrapment mechanism, fast growing crystals will entrap or trap the portion of the solution present during the precipitation. For example, this is solution and in this solution precipitate is fastly growing like this. So due to fast growing of the precipitate, this crystal will entrap a portion of solution. This is portion of solution. So this solution will be trapped by this precipitate or a crystal and it will be present in the pocket like structure of the crystal. Now coming to the next mechanism, that is adsorption. Under this mechanism, many impurities will be adsorbed on the surface of the precipitate. For example, we are having the crystal like this. Then impurities will be adsorbed on the surface of this crystal. So these are the mechanism of co-precipitation, and this is the complete detail about precipitation and co-precipitation under gravimetric analysis. In my next video, I will discuss about various steps involved in gravimetric analysis. Thank you.